This weekend, Hallmark's Christmas in July begins with Christmas at the Fireworks Stand. He's a buff CrossFit competitor with rippling pecs and a bad case of ED, who owns a chain of fireworks stands. She's a smoking hot professional cabinet maker who's trying to balance extreme shyness with a love of hard wood. Is his firecracker a dud? Or will sparks fly? Come on, what are you, a Yankee Doodle dummy? It's Christmas at the Fireworks Stand, all this weekend on the Hallmark Channel.
KHJ Los Angeles.
Portions of the day's programming are reproduced by means of electrical transcriptions or tape recording.
You're listening to the radio.
He came and he grabbed the food, and then he came again for the soda.
So, another Jack Glazed salmon and anything for you.
Wait, what is Jack Glaze?
It's our special sauce that we put on the salmon. It's molasses and honey and Jack Daniels.
It has alcohol in it? No, he doesn't drink.
Oh, don't worry. The alcohol cooks down with the fish.
But what if you get the sauce on the side and it isn't cooked with the fish?
That would explain why we have so many drunk kids here.
Unfortunately, something horrible happened. I don't think it's anybody's fault. It's just one of those things. It's an accident for a reason.
That is so stupid.
Getting drunk in the morning. Who are you, Kathy Lee Gifford?
We may not hook up with women, but we really understand women.
Guess what it is today?
July 5th.
It just so happens to be National Bikini Day.
So it's National Bikini Day.
Get excited about it. It's going to be wonderful.
In honor of National Bikini Day.
I got a new bikini.
I have that same bikini.
I need another bikini.
Buy me a new bikini.
The day set aside for everybody to recognize and celebrate the bikini.
Come on, bikini inspector.
Showtime.
Did you wear your bikini?
No.
You might want to pull your microphone
okay.
in. Oh, there it is.
Is it good? I was leaning the wrong way. I don't own one.
Really?
I mean...
Well, you can borrow ours. It's Drake, everybody. So, take two. Are you wearing your bikini?
Yes.
Underneath your shirt. That's awesome.
I didn't know it was National Bikini Day, though. I just put it on.
Yeah, I mean, coincidence, isn't it? Yeah. It's The Mike Show. Thank you for joining us on Radio 434, the Radio 434 apps, and radio434.com. You can also get us on the Alexa.
On the Alexa, I said.
Hello! There we go. Nothing's working today properly. How do you get our live channel, our live show, and our feature channel on Alexa, you ask? It's a query.
How do you do it?
Well, it's very, very simple. You simply enable the skill. You just do that one time. You say, Alexa, enable the Radio 434 skill. And she will. And then every time after that you want to listen, you just say, Alexa, play Radio 434. Our podcast is even easier to find. You just say, Alexa, play the Mike Show VA podcast. You have to add the VA in there. And will she? Well, yes, she will. You can also find us on Apple and Spotify, Amazon Music, RSS.com, pretty much everywhere you get your podcasts. Just search The Mike Show VA. And you can even watch the show on our Facebook Live at The Mike Show VA. It's really, really easy. And you can check out Drake's shirt.
Oh, yeah.
Pretty awesome.
I didn't know what to wear today. If I would have known I was on video, I don't know.
Well, sorry for the surprise.
It's Star Wars.
It is Star Wars. Coming up on today's program, of course, we've got your five random facts. We're going to get smarter. We're going to get even smarter-est with Nerd News. It's This Week in Science. It's just science. Don't be afraid. But then we're going to get really stupid with your stupid criminals in the news. And then I've got the 4th of July roundup. Just stuff. Stuff that happened on America's Day.
America's Day.
Yeah, America's Day. So we're going to talk about that. And we have our top list. Top reasons America rocks. All right.
There's only five.
I think there's a couple more. There's a couple more, and I don't know why. I think the writers are being cute when they say the top five, and maybe that's pick your top five. But we always read everything the writers give us, literally. And if they wrote a swear word on there, we'd read it.
Read it.
Because we're very Ron Burgundy that way. So, Drake.
Yes.
What's going on, man?
Work, I guess.
Work.
And, you know.
And stuff. And things.
And stuff.
Yeah.
It was 4th of July yesterday. Didn't really do anything.
How'd you celebrate the 4th?
Well, I was going to work.
Yeah.
And then we realized everything downtown was closed.
Okay.
So we didn't open.
And so
I went and had lunch with a friend. And then my girlfriend got off work. And then we went and hung out with a few friends like outside of the restaurant.
Mm-hmm.
And then we got dinner together at King's Island.
Oh, nice.
It is so good.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my God.
And then played Monopoly.
You played Monopoly.
We didn't finish the game, though. It was one of those games where it went too long.
Okay, so nobody tipped the board.
No.
Nobody tipped the board. Nobody got so frustrated that they tipped the board.
Everyone thinks that they won, so.
Okay, that's great.
We're going to finish the game.
Yeah. We've got some guests that are going to be joining us as well. That and so much more is the Mike Show. This portion of the broadcast is brought to you in part by Centra Health.
This is a care team at Centra.
Hello!
A team of experts who partner with you.
Hey, Jackie, how are you?
A doctor oversees your care.
The team will take great care of you.
An advanced practice provider is there for routine and sick visits.
All right, I'll get that prescription called in for you.
Thank you.
And an RN leads your nursing team.
Your numbers are looking great.
Getting you the personalized care you need.
And that takes a team.
Count on Centra because it's your life.
We help you live it.
From brand new to lightly used, CMA's Honda of Lynchburg's got you covered. Shop our growing selection today and find our best deals on our entire inventory. That's savings on every single vehicle. And on our used cars, take 3 days to love it or leave it. Plus, we'll buy your current vehicle. Trade in with us and get an unbeatable offer. Start shopping and saving today. CMA's Honda of Lynchburg. Owners just care more.
Three Roads Brewery is Lynchburg's gathering spot. Enjoy the relaxed open atmosphere of the Lynchburg Tap Room with plenty of space to unwind or outside on their expansive patio with friends and the entire family. Check out Three Roads games, arcade style, darts, and more. And of course, an excellent selection of craft beers brewed on site. Grab a Three Roads today at their tap room, 1300 Court Street, downtown Lynchburg, their tap room in Farmville, or anywhere they serve great beer. Three Roads is also available at area convenience stores and supermarkets. And if they don't carry Three Roads, ask them to. Brewing community. Three Roads Brewery.
Coming to you live from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their Factory Direct Warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF!
And now it's time for another episode of A Few Seconds Inside a Man's Head.
I should not be lighting these fireworks with my lighter. I'm all right.
And that was another episode of A Few Seconds Inside a Man's Head.
No, he probably shouldn't. The Mike Show. So you were just showing me that L.A.
Yeah.
banned fireworks. And this is how residents of L.A. responded. I might be able to.
We can pull it up on the internet.
Yeah, I might be able. If you just share it to my. Share it via Messenger. And then I can literally just share it to my Messenger, yeah. And then I'll pull it up. And then I'll fix the levels. Since nothing is working properly here today. it's the Mike Show. It's the Finally Friday edition. Thank God it's Friday.
Oh, yeah.
It actually felt a little bit more like Monday today because, you know, we had yesterday off.
Everything was closed.
Yeah. Well, if you can find it, then just share it to me. But, yeah, L.A. responded by everyone shooting off fireworks. Literally, the entire city.
Yeah.
It looked like the biggest fireworks show that anybody had ever seen.
I just sent it to your Facebook.
Oh, okay, cool. Let me find it. Skip for now. Drake. Here we go.
It's a TikTok, so I don't know if you can pull it up, but...
Yeah. I think so.
God bless our troops!
Here we go. And then hit share screen. There. Boom. Okay.
Yeah.
There you go. That's how they responded.
There's a helicopter. If you look, there's a helicopter flying.
Yeah.
And they're just like, they have no idea what to do.
Here, there we go. Look.
It's a helicopter.
That's everything. That's how they responded to banning the fireworks. There you go.
They're not going to catch anybody.
No, they're not going to be able to catch
them
all.
Why would they even do it?
Yeah. Yeah. Anyway. The Mike Show. So, let's do our 4th of July roundup. How about that? According to the American Farm Bureau, the average 4th of July cookout cost $71.22 this year, up 5%. That's for a group of 10 people.
How much was it?
$71.22. Really? For 10 mm-hmm. people?
For 10 people, it's 7...
Yeah. What, for cheeseburgers, chicken, pork chops, beans, potato salad. We went to Tabs... We went to Tabs' aunt's barbecue or cookout, and they just did hot dogs and then a whole bunch of sides.
Yeah.
So I think cost wise it was probably
thought,
a little bit less.
Groceries are so high now. So I thought maybe it'd be even over $100.
I mean, pretty darn close. Yeah. I went to the grocery store twice yesterday because I did too. Well, Tab. Tab wanted to make a pasta salad to take to her aunt's house, and we were out of Italian dressing, so I had to go to the store anyway. So I went to the store, and then I bought all the stuff to make shrimp boil, which I did last night. I did a low country shrimp boil last night for dinner.
Shrimp boil.
But then whenever I got back to the house, I was getting ready to start the shrimp boil. I realized we didn't have any Old Bay.
Oh.
So now I had to go back to the store again, and I spent so much money just with that. Oh, and then we stopped at Sheetz and we got beer.
Yeah.
So, I mean,
that's also
it was
why
crazy.
I thought the cost would be higher, because, yeah, you have the food and the snacks and the chips
and
the sodas,
and
but beer.
Beverages. Oh, beer. Yeah, definitely beer. 4th of July gas prices. They're fairly steady. Maybe even a little down from last year. Gas Buddy expects the average price to be about $3.49 a gallon. That's down a penny from last year. Way down from 2 years ago at $4.79.
Oh, yeah, I remember
that. That was right after Russia invaded the Ukraine. This isn't Russia. It's not Russia. A new study ranked the best barbecue cities.
Ooh.
They put Kansas City, Missouri at the top. The rest of the top five are Memphis, Houston, Kansas City, Kansas, and Los Angeles, but don't shoot off any fireworks there.
No. They'll get you.
They won't get anybody. A new poll.
Pull over.
A new poll found 83% of us are proud to be American.
You said how many?
83% of us.
83%.
That's how many said at least somewhat proud. Only 3% said not proud at all. Wallet Hub. They did an annual ranking of the most patriotic states. Virginia.
Oh.
Number one. Virginia's number one. Followed by Alaska, Montana, Maine, Oregon, Arkansas. They ranked last. Arkansas ranked last as the most patriotic state?
Wait, so Texas is not even in the top 10?
Well, here, let's...
To me, I feel like...
I'm not biased,
but still, like, Texas seems like it's like America.
America. Here, let's...
But Virginia makes sense.
Yeah,
Maine surprised me.
Okay, let's do the rankings here. Virginia, number one.
Yeah, okay. Alaska.
Number one. Alaska, number two.
That's crazy.
Montana, Maine, Oregon, Colorado, New Hampshire, Washington State, Maryland, number nine. Hawaii at number 10.
What?
Yeah, really. And now let's scroll down. Let's find Texas.
That's crazy.
California's 35th. That doesn't surprise me.
Yeah.
West by God, Virginia, they're 41. That surprises me a lot.
Texas is 30-something, I think.
Where?
36?
Oh, yeah. 36.
That's crazy.
That is crazy. Now,
how is Alaska more American than Texas?
Yeah, and what was the...
No offense to Alaska.
No. No offense at all. But I wonder what the criteria was. Wallet Hub's ranking. Well, anyway, our perception of the average American isn't great, though. The top words we'd use to describe our fellow Americans are selfish, spoiled, undisciplined. When the same poll was done in 1948, the top picks were generous, confident. But even then, selfish and spoiled were tied for third.
Oh, wow.
A poll asked people which freedoms are most important to America's identity. Number one is a tie for the right to vote and equal protection under the law. Freedom of speech ranked third, followed by the right to privacy and freedom of religion.
Oh, wow.
And question for you.
Okay.
Does the American dream still exist? Young people are more likely to say no.
I still have people, and they're not, I guess, they could be any age, still tell me, it's America, man. You got to be proud to be American.
American.
Even yesterday, you know, I was at lunch, and there was, you know, we're in Virginia, so we're in Central Virginia.
Yeah.
So you'll have people that are, like, you know, going all out for 4th of July, and there are people, you know, you got to be proud to be American. Well, and I like the American dream, I think, is not dead, but I think there's very few people that really believe in it.
Yeah. And again, you know, younger people are more likely to say the American dream doesn't
still
exist.
But what is
the
American dream?
Well, it's, you know, it's the home ownership. It's the you know, okay, being able to purchase real estate. It's, you know, start your own business, pull yourself up by your bootstraps and all that. And I think a lot of young people get a bad rap because you are one of the hardest working individuals I have ever met. And you are, and you work so many different jobs to make a living. And you do it, and you know. So if you
is that the American dream then? Because I don't own a house.
Well,
I live in a house.
Well, I mean, I don't own a house now either.
So is that the? I mean, yeah. I get it because I know, like, probably like you said in that one fun fact in the 40s and 50s, if you were to ask someone what the American dream was, they'd probably been like fighting for our rights.
Yeah,
home ownership.
And
nowadays, I feel like you just gotta. I don't know. American dream is living.
I think it still exists. 17% of seniors said definitely not, compared to 30% of folks under 30. Now, as far as that goes, you know, things have changed quite a bit. We've talked about the gig economy, where I personally would rather do a whole bunch of different things, and collectively make the amount of money that I make doing a whole bunch of different things rather than relying on one thing or one, you know, full-time gig or one, you know, one boss that would pay me, you know, X amount of dollars. Yeah. Because, you know, what happens if that business goes under? What happens if that boss, you know, retires or gets fired and then you're out? Everybody.
That's so, what happened. You know, you said I worked 3 jobs.
Yeah.
Thank you. I know I do work a lot. It's fine.
You work
it's
a lot.
And, like, it's, you know, yesterday was 4th of July. Everything was closed.
Yeah.
One of my jobs was open. I was not working yesterday. That's crazy to me. We were one of the only places yesterday that were open.
I didn't even realize that it was going to be open.
Yeah.
And yeah,
for me, you know, working is, like, the only way to live. And so I feel like the American dream is, like, the way to live. Like, you, no matter what you do, like, yeah, I would rather have one good gig, right? It'd be great. Right now, it's kind of hard to find that.
Yeah.
And the 3 jobs that I have are fun, and it's... You know, I work at the arcade, the record store, and the brewery.
Okay, Drake, how old are you?
24.
Dude, that's the American dream.
I mean, but then some people say at 24 you shouldn't be working, man. You should be having fun, which I have fun. But you
are having fun too, I guess.
Yeah.
I hope.
Well, yeah, I mean.
Finally, on this.
Yes, last one.
Going to a parade, a writer for CNN did an op-ed titled, "Let's Stop Pretending That Parades Are Fun." Now, my youngest daughter went with her grandpa to a parade, which is one of the longest running parades in our area. And now she went because she loves to get the candy. She's 9 years old.
I do that still.
Are parades fun? We used to be, Drake, we used to be in the giant balloon parade business.
You or?
Yeah, me. A friend of mine, Bill. Wow. And Bill might be watching right now. Bill Smith, Smith Special Productions. And it's a giant parade balloon company. And we've had them. We've had the balloons here in Lynchburg. We've had some of them. From, you know, mostly for Christmas Christmas parades or Santa's parades and things like that. So those types of parades are fun. I don't like clowns.
Really? Are you definitely afraid of clowns?
Oh, yeah, it's like...
It? You won't watch that movie?
I watched it, but it was really difficult. But clowns in general, like in my face, not on TV so much, but clowns in general in my face. And I know that the Shriners do such great work, but man, when I see them coming, I'm like,
did something happen as a child that triggered this?
I don't want to talk about it.
Okay, no, it's fine.
I don't want to talk about it.
No, I get it.
All right, so according to the CNN writer, quote, I don't think parades are going away anytime soon. I just want people to stop pretending that they actually enjoy them.
I remember as a kid, like you said, your daughter, I remember going to parades as a kid, and even in March, when I was in high school, marching band, we played in the in the parades.
So did I.
And it's like, it was fun. I'm not going to say it wasn't fun.
Yeah.
But I think this past year, Thanksgiving,
yeah,
I put on the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade.
Yeah, yeah.
And I sat there and watched it, and I was like, ooh.
That brings us to our top list. In honor of the country that we spent the 4th of July drinking, eating, blowing off our appendages with bottle rockets to celebrate, enjoy today's list. It's our top list today. Top reasons America rocks. All right, here we go. Number one, our churches offer eternal salvation.
What?
And fried chicken. Top reasons America rocks. We think the news is fake and wrestling is real.
I agree with that.
Top reasons America rocks. Shh. If you listen carefully, you can hear rascal scooters beeping. Top reasons America rocks. It's the only country whose president was alive for its birth. For its birth. Top reasons America rocks. Did any other country devote this summer to guys who look like rats? No, sir. No. Top reasons America rocks. Guess where you can find all 1,900 Waffle Houses?
In America.
Hint. Not Ecuador. Nope. America.
There's no Waffle House in California.
No Waffle House in California.
It's the East Coast thing.
Ain't no sunshine when she's gone.
They've never eaten Waffle House.
What?
Yeah.
That's bonkers.
If you look at a map of it, it's all East Coast and down in Texas, kind of, but like not anywhere California.
No wonder what's wrong with California. There's
no
wonder.
Waffle Houses.
No Waffle Houses. You get some Waffle Houses out there.
There you go.
You're living right. Top reasons America rocks. Our pop stars can juggle knives. Hot dogs are a food group.
Yeah.
We think mechanical bulls and alcohol makes a great combination.
Amen.
Top reasons America rocks. Our kids may not know how to read, write, or count, but they sure as heck know the Ten Commandments. There you go. Top reasons America rocks. We celebrate its birthday. Take two. Top reasons America rocks. We celebrate its birthday by waving flags made in China. I said made in China.
Hello.
There she is. And watching fireworks imported from Mexico. And there you go. That's your top list today. The Mike Show. Coming up. What the hell are we going to do? We've got news. And not headline news. That's all on the way. This portion of our broadcast is brought to you in part by CMA's Honda of Lynchburg.
Looking for a dealership you can trust? CMA's Honda of Lynchburg is here for you. Our legacy of quality service speaks for itself. Drive away today in a Honda that's perfect for you. Trusted by the Lynchburg community for years. CMA's Honda of Lynchburg. Owners just care more.
This is Jackie.
Hi.
Jackie is feeling really good.
I sure am.
Tell everybody why, Jackie.
Well, because I've got my own care team at Centra.
You sure do.
Yep, I've got my doctor.
Leading your team.
My advanced practice provider.
Who's there if you're sick or for yearly visits.
And my registered nurse.
Leads your nursing team.
At Centra, I'm getting personal care from a team of experts.
No wonder you're feeling good.
Really good.
To learn how Centra can help you, like they're helping Jackie, go to CentraHealth.com.
You gotta love the juice at Jersey Mike's. That zing of real red wine vinegar and olive oil blend is even better than the zing of a first kiss. No offense to Brenda DeMarche. It was a fine first smooch for me behind the bleachers. But there's nothing like when that zing of the juice hits your lips for the very first time. Years later, Brenda and I shared a Jersey Mike's sub with extra juice. We had a better time because neither of us had braces.
Add a flavor zing with the juice. Jersey Mike's. A sub above.
Broadcasting from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their factory direct warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF.
This is not headline news. Yesterday was the 4th of July, the day where rednecks spend hundreds of dollars on fireworks while whining how bad inflation is. Post Malone celebrates a birthday today, which is fitting since it looks like a firecracker blew up in his face. Kevin Costner says he's open to falling in love again. And just like that, America's found our next golden bachelor. And Huey Lewis turned 74 today. Nowadays, when he wants a new drug, it's Viagra. This is not headline news.
No, it's not. It's the Mike Show. It's the, what is today? Today's Friday. I am so confused because of 4th of July being on Thursday. Then we were off Thursday. And then now we probably should have taken the whole damn week off.
Well, I mean, I'm surprised.
Yeah.
Today, everything's going to be open, then we have the fireworks.
Yeah.
But
yeah,
I wonder if there's things that won't be open.
Well, no, I think everything will be open.
Everything's open today.
But most people and the like business professionals and stuff and all that, most people are taking off this whole week.
Yeah.
We have an event at Three Roads tomorrow, though. Santa Claus is coming to town.
Santa! Yep.
Santa, I know him! Yeah, Santa's going to be there at Three Roads for, well, it's Summer Santa, and he'll be there. It's
Christmas in July.
So come on out. He's there from 1 to 3. Bring the kids. Have a great time. You can check out all our decorations. I still have more things to decorate. I have to get the truck and I have to load up stuff and haul it. But I think
so it's not just a tree that you
It's
brought.
Not just one tree. Yeah. Jamerson Lewis actually sponsored that tree and they did the tree. And it's so cool. You can bid on that tree and the winning bidder at the end of the month takes that tree home with them. Yeah, including all the decorations and everything. We'll just
new tree.
Yeah, we're just gonna saran wrap the whole thing up, and you can take it home.
They have the yellow, the not yellow snow.
Yeah,
white snow stuff on there that like you know, it was glittery and everything.
Well,
yellow snow.
You know, after
Christmas in July, yellow snow.
After a night or two, there might be some yellow snow on there. Who knows? Anyway, but that's not why we're here.
No.
So off air, we were talking about the. Adam Sandler movies.
Just, yeah.
And I absolutely positively love Adam Sandler movies. And you had some fun facts about them.
Well, I mean, we were talking about Uncut Gems, and he said that if he didn't win an Oscar, he would make the worst movie that he's ever made.
Yeah.
And which was Hubie Halloween.
Hubie Halloween.
And I thought it was pretty funny.
For an Adam Sandler movie, It was actually on par. It was not as good as Billy Madison.
I have the list that I pulled up.
Well, I'm gonna give you my favorite Adam Sandler flicks. I love Billy Madison's always gonna be one of my favorites, one of my top picks. Okay, and I'm constantly. Today, Junior. I'm constantly quoting that movie. And whenever we go to the beach or we go to the pool and I'm spraying the kids and I go, suntan lotion is good for me. You'll protect me. Tee hee hee.
Your kids probably have no idea.
They know it. They know it perfectly. Ultraviolet rays are bad. Suntan lotion good. Oh, man. And
he sees the penguin.
Yes.
And no one else sees it.
Penguin, it's too damn hot to be just walking around here. That,
back to school. Yeah. Back to school.
Okay, I'm sorry.
I am not a fool.
That is the greatest Adam Sandler movie of all times.
Happy Gilmore. How
Happy Gilmore I love. And you
said that's a good premise. They're doing a second one apparently.
Really?
Yes, I looked it up. I think Adam Sandler was like, I want to do a second one.
Do you want to know the Adam Sandler movie that made me cry?
Oh, okay.
Guess what it was?
Well, let me look through all his then. My idea, and I watched it, this movie.
Yeah.
Spaceman.
No, that
and
one.
I liked it.
That one did not make me cry.
And a lot of people didn't like that one, and I really liked it. I thought it was a very interesting. Oh, Click made you cry?
Oh my God. Okay, number one, I'm a dad. Okay,
yeah.
I'm a dad, and I got kids, and I got a little. My youngest is 9, but you know, back when that movie came out, she was little. Yeah, you know, she little. Was little. And
I only remember it being funny.
And oh man,
that's the thing, I don't remember it being sad.
Rewatch it.
I need to.
Rewatch it. He basically spends a whole, and I don't want to spoil it for anybody that has not watched this film, but he basically spends an entire life like clicking through and skipping.
Yeah, he can, like, go back or something, right?
No, he
like,
can't.
Oh, he can't go back.
He can't go back. So he's fast forwarding through his life. And then he, you know, he like wakes up and it's been 10 years and he wakes up again. It's been another 10 years and he's missed all this stuff in his life, including his dad passing away, including his. It's a sad movie, dude. You have to rewatch it.
It's on Hulu.
Yeah, you got to rewatch it from that perspective.
I'll watch it.
You will be bawling. I guarantee you. I will bet
it's
you
just
five.
So funny because I just remember that movie's supposed to be a comedy.
I'll bet you $5.
I probably will cry.
I'll bet you $5. You'll be bawling.
Knowing me, I will.
Now
cry.
With this new perspective, but yeah, that movie is probably one of my favorite. Newer Adam Sandler movies.
Older, new.
But then, you know, he was doing that whole the Jennifer Aniston thing.
The murder mystery thing.
Yeah.
I never watched him.
I love them both. They were both excellent. He did the.
I had the first one's better than the second one.
50 First Dates. He was doing
that's
the whole.
That's a great movie.
Yeah, I love that. I love that one.
Such a good movie.
And then the Blended.
That's a good one, too.
Yeah.
Wow.
All of these.
Drew Barrymore's in both of those.
Right, exactly. I love the... and then the whole ensemble cast where he's got the same group.
Yeah, he's got
the same core.
Kevin James,
you know,
Chris Rock.
And this is, you know, in even going back to... What was the one where he owned the pizza shop?
And then
he inherited... Mr. Deeds!
Yeah,
Mr. Deeds
is so good too. Like, I forgot.
This dude is so incredible with his films, and everybody just thinks he's an ass clown.
Oh, did you ever see The Cobbler?
I did.
He's a cobbler.
Yes. I have seen The Cobbler.
That one was pretty good.
That one was good.
Grown Ups has always been good.
Grown Ups they're decent. That's got his whole ensemble cast. As you mentioned, we just watched again last night. The Wedding Singer.
Oh, yeah. I still have yet to see that.
Another Drew Barrymore.
Oh, really? Oh, wow. He's really worked with Drew Barrymore.
Another Drew Barrymore in that one. But I think he's a brilliant actor. He got robbed with Uncut Gems.
And then he made Hubie Halloween.
And
it's not even that. It's basically like
the
Water Boy.
Oh, good Lord! There's so many.
My dad. Oh, this is a funny story. So when I played Little League football, you know, I like football. You know, I'll hit, I'll tackle.
Yeah.
But I also never really liked being hit.
Yeah.
Guys were bigger. Like And there was one day that my dad's like, "You just got to hit him. You got to hit him." And so he told me right after, like, we did a drill. Like, I like hit this, you know, hit the kid, and we tackle each other, and he gets done, and my dad's laughing, and I'm like, "Why?" And he goes, "Have you ever seen Waterboy?" And I go, "No." And he goes, "We got to watch that tonight. What you just did." And so for a good the whole year, I just
you visualize.
I visualized. Did the noise like every time I ran. I was like, from I think 8 or 9, I watched The Waterboy for the first time.
Oh,
and
my God. That's excellent.
It's a great movie.
Excellent. It is really,
my
really good.
My mom said alligators are so ornery because they don't have anyone to brush their teeth.
All right. So you have the list.
Well, I'm going through the ranking of... It's 51 movies. I'm not going to read all 51.
No,
so the top 30, I'm going to brush through them, I guess. At number 30 is Don't Mess With the Zohan. Which I heard was really garbage.
Let's do the top 10.
Let's do the top 10.
Let's do the bottom five.
Okay, one that's on here that I haven't talked about, and it's really funny, is I Now Pronounce You Chuck and Larry.
That's another excellent movie.
But the top 10, let's see. I got to skip. Okay, come on. Internet. Let's see. I'm seeing some that are on here that I'm like surprised that are not higher. All of his Hotel Transylvania movies are on here.
Oh, those are also good, excellent.
I mean, they're good movies. Let's see. Okay, top. Here we go. This is taking too long. Let's see.
Yeah, Murder Mystery 2 is coming out.
I heard the first one. I watched, I think, a little bit of the first
excellent.
One.
It was excellent.
Let's see. It's not loading for me. Oh, Bedtime Stories. I totally forgot about that.
I don't think I ever saw
that
one.
The one where he has to... The Gumballs Rain. You don't remember that one?
I don't remember that one.
The kids will love it.
I don't remember that one.
Spanglish.
I don't remember that one.
Really? Okay, do you remember 8 Crazy Nights, his animated movie that he did?
Yes,
okay.
I didn't like that one.
You didn't like that one.
Yeah, it was iron.
Okay, Mr. Deeds is 16.
Okay.
Click is 15. So number 15 is Click, and you said you
That's
loved,
one yeah. of my favorites. Yeah.
Anger Management.
That was a good
I've
one.
I've never seen that.
Little Nicky.
That's the one that everyone hates, but it's not bad.
I love that one.
Hustle.
And Big Daddy.
Big Daddy's good. Okay, 51st Dates is 12.
Okay.
Funny People is 11. I don't know that one.
You Be Halloween.
Rain Over Me is 10. I guess it's a serious one. Airheads. Oh, yeah. It's the Brendan Fraser.
Yeah, Airheads.
Steve Buscemi. That's a good one.
That was excellent.
Waterboy is number 8.
Yeah.
I don't know that movie. It's... New and Selected, the Miro Witch stories. I guess it's a serious movie. Punch Drunk Love.
Okay.
Billy Madison is number 5.
Billy Madison. What is number 1?
Happy Gilmore's number 4. Okay. Number 1? Oh, Wedding Singer's number 2.
Really?
Number 1 is Big Daddy.
Big Daddy.
I'm okay with that.
I'm okay with that.
That's a great... I remember watching that movie as a kid.
Yeah, yeah.
It's the Sprouse brothers. Cole and Dylan Sprouse.
I'm definitely okay with that.
Yeah, Adam Sandler is just all around, though.
He really is.
The least rated, though, on that list, number 51, was Ridiculous 6.
what was the bottom 5?
Bottom 5.
Yeah.
Which I think is very not, I'm not going to say is correct. I would redo this list a little bit, but.
Of course you would.
I probably would. The worst movies on here, apparently. Number 51, Ridiculous 6.
Okay.
Number 50 is Jack and Jill, and I don't agree with that.
I do.
Zookeeper, which is Kevin James's movie that he did.
Yeah.
The Do-Over, which is a Netflix original, which is 48.
I actually liked Do-Over.
Yeah, Mixed Nuts, Steve Martin movie. I don't know that one.
Oh, my God, that is a classic.
I've never seen it.
That is a classic, and it's incredible, and I totally forgot...
About that movie?
Yeah. Well, no, I totally forgot that he was in it.
Well, he guest stars in a lot of movies.
Yeah, but that was actually one of the first ones, one of the first movies that he did. Do you remember Remote Control on MTV?
No.
No, you That's don't. Do you remember when MTV played music videos?
Like, yeah.
Like, all the time?
No. I was 99.
Yeah.
So I know all of that stuff.
Yeah.
But I wasn't there for it.
Yeah, yeah. So anyway, there was this thing called MTV that actually played music videos. And then they started doing some specialty programming and some
reality
comedy things
TV
and stuff.
Now
they do that crap. But they had a game show on called Remote Control. And Adam Sandler, this was his first role, he would come out and he was like... He was Shakespeare guy or something. He would come out and he would sing ridiculous songs, which is pretty much on par for Adam Sandler.
Well, yeah.
Around that time, Mixed Nuts came out, and he was one of the cast of Mixed Nuts. That's one of our favorite Christmas movies.
Oh, it's a, okay, it's a Christmas
Yeah, it's a Christmas movie.
I might have to watch it then, because I do like a good Christmas movie.
Yep. All right, so we've devoted almost 14 minutes to Adam Sandler. You're welcome.
I mean, we didn't have to.
No, I wanted to. It was a great topic.
Talk about that. I'll talk about movies all day.
Talk about movies all day as well. Maybe that's the Drake thing. Maybe we do a movie segment and we do a music segment. Yeah, that would be cool. Coming up, we are going to get even more smarter with your five random facts. This portion of the broadcast is brought to you in part by Jersey Mike's Subs.
At Jersey Mike's, they slice your order fresh right in front of you. And let me tell you, watching that can send a rush of emotions through a person. Excitement, impatience, baby-like wonder, indecisive, anticipatory chewing, nervous pacing, happy claps, and finally, jealousy, because that's this guy's sub. I should order one. Good idea.
Sliced right in front of you. It's a Jersey Mike's thing. A sub above.
The Battle of 460 returns as the Lynchburg Hillcats face off against the Salem Red Sox July 1st through the 6th at Bank of the James Stadium. Join us for Independence Day celebration on Thursday with the biggest fireworks show in the Hill City. This year, we'll be honoring the historic Bedford boys with specialty jerseys. Come back again on Friday as we give away a Hillcats Patriotic cap. Then on Saturday, we'll turn our attention to a galaxy far, far away with the Revenge of the 6th. Get your tickets today at Lynchburg-Hillcats.com.
Hi, I'm Megan Huffman with Share Greater Lynchburg. Share is an online platform that helps neighbors discover ways to support, serve, or shop for over 150 local area nonprofits all in one place, 365 days a year. You can learn more at ShareGreaterLynchburg.org.
Coming to you live from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their factory direct warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at StonecraftersVA.com.
K-H-F.
And now it's time for
five
random
facts.
Yep, that time of the day we cram your head full of usable information, and you can tell it back wherever the heck you happen to be. We don't know where you go or what you do, and quite frankly, it's really none of our business. But if you say any of these five random facts back, someone in the room is bound to say,
wow.
I don't know. Maybe you never know.
Or they might just tell you to shut up.
Yeah, they might. All right, so Darius said, you know, it's just me today. I'm heading in a minute. Okay. Yep, no problem. All right, we can do that. Here we go. Five random facts. Number one, the largest single firework ever made weighed almost 3,000 pounds, or about as heavy as a Toyota Corolla. It was the grand finale at a display in Steamboat Springs, Colorado in 2020.
Colorado.
There's a video. Look it up. I'm not going to play it for you.
That's crazy.
Number two, fireworks are just simple chemical reactions, which require three key components: an oxidizer, a fuel, and a chemical mixture to produce the color. In early fireworks, saltpeter was the oxidizing ingredient. What the hell is saltpeter?
Saltpeter. Saint Peter.
Let's Google saltpeter. It occurs in nature as a mineral. Nitra outside the U.S. It's a source of nitrogen, and nitrogen was named after nitre. Potassium nitrate is one of several nitrogen-containing compounds collectively referred to as saltpeter. Okay. All right. That's fine.
You learn something new every day.
I didn't learn anything.
I didn't retain any of that.
No, I'm not going to remember any of it. Number two. That was number two. Yeah. Number three. The colors are from different elements. Strontium and lithium compounds produce deep reds. Copper produces blues. Titanium and magnesium burn silver or white. Calcium creates the color orange. Sodium produces yellow pyrotechnics. And barium burns green. I did not know any of this. I didn't know how they made all those colors.
I thought it was dye.
Ooh, and now you can make like shapes. I saw
shapes.
Fireworks made that looked like a cowboy hat. All right, number four.
America.
The sounds that fireworks make are also chemical reactions. Huh. Layers of organic salt combined with an oxidizer, potassium perchlorate, how do you pronounce this?
Sure.
Here, let's get our pronunciation key. How to pronounce percolate?
Perchlorate.
Oh, it's our pronounceify lady here.
Perchlorate.
Okay,
perchlorate.
Now it makes sense. Perchlorate.
I'm learning.
Perchlorate.
Yeah. So it's perchlorate.
Perchlorate.
She's annoyed.
Just say it already.
As each layer burns, it slowly releases a gas, creating the whistling sound associated with fireworks rockets. Aluminum or iron flakes can create hissing or sizzling sparkles, while titanium powder creates loud blasts and white sparks. Those are the boom, the big boom. Fireworks, number five, are dangerous. And not just when handled by drunk people. The chemicals in them are not good for the environment. Exploding a firework releases heavy metal, dioxins, and other pollutants into the air. These pollutants can cause serious health effects in high doses, including lung problems, thyroid problems, and birth defects. Yeah. I guess we should ban them.
Well, that didn't really go well in LA. So they say if you inhale, like...
Oh, yeah, don't huff. Yeah, don't huff the fireworks.
Well, I'm not going to do that.
Don't huff fireworks.
Don't give anybody any ideas. Don't do that.
No, don't do that.
Don't do that.
Don't do that. That's weird.
What I'm saying, though, is like we set off some yesterday. No, I didn't.
What we're saying is don't.
But like if you let it off.
Don't huff
those. You shouldn't be around smoke.
No.
Okay. That's what I'm saying. Is like I didn't know that was bad. I didn't know that was like that bad.
Well, it's all those. We just.
I know. I was like, dang.
Read all the and talk about the saltpeter.
I mean the saltpeter.
Yeah. I mean magnesium and what was this? Aluminum, iron, titanium.
We really did kill the environment yesterday. LA, you screwed up.
Yep. And then they're coming for you. Yeah. And those are your five random facts.
The Mike Show. Oh, let's play the outro.
This has been today's edition of
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Random
facts. Yep. Perchlorate.
The Mike Show.
Perchlorate.
Coming up, we're going to open up the science lab, and we've got your nerd news this week in science. It's just science. Don't be afraid. That is all on the way. We'll get even more smarter. So you get two smarts for one stupid on this show on a Friday. This portion of the broadcast is brought to you in part by Centra Health.
This is a care team at Centra.
Hello!
A team of experts who partner with you.
Hey, Jackie, how are you?
A doctor oversees your care.
The team will take great care of you.
An advanced practice provider is there for routine and sick visits.
All right, I'll get that prescription called in for you.
Thank you.
And an RN leads your nursing team.
Your numbers are looking great.
Getting you the personalized care you need.
And that takes a team.
Count on Centra, because it's your life.
And we help you live it.
Join us down at the Lynchburg Community Market and experience all that one of the nation's oldest farmers markets has to offer. Grab some lunch from our restaurants and shops, or shop from our awesome selection of artisan, handmade goods in our crafters gallery. Swing by on Saturday to check out our farmers market, where you can shop from the freshest selection of local grown produce, meats, and more. The Lynchburg Community Market, located in downtown Lynchburg on the corner of 12th and Main Street. Open Tuesday through Saturday from 7 to 2 year-round. For more information, follow us on Facebook and Instagram at Lynchburg Community Market.
Three Roads Brewery is Lynchburg's gathering spot. Enjoy the relaxed open atmosphere of the Lynchburg Tap Room with plenty of space to unwind or outside on their expansive patio with friends and the entire family. Check out Three Roads games, arcade style, darts, and more. And of course, an excellent selection of craft beers brewed on site. Grab a Three Roads today at their tap room, 1300 Court Street, downtown Lynchburg, their tap room in Farmville, or anywhere they serve great beer. Three Roads is also available at area convenience stores and supermarkets. And if they don't carry Three Roads, ask them to. Brewing Community. Three Roads Brewery.
Broadcasting from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their factory direct warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF.
It is the Mike Show. It's the finally Friday edition, and we have guests aplenty. And the going, what is this? This would be stage left to stage right. This is Gail, and Gail, I officially am finally getting a chance to meet you. You are our favorite Santa's wife.
Thank you.
And Santa will be at Three Roads, and that's not why you're here, but I wanted to mention that, and we'll talk about that a little bit later on. But I've never officially met you.
No.
So
no, we haven't officially met until today.
So, well, welcome to the program.
Thank you.
I'm delighted to officially meet you. And Kat, I'm delighted to meet you.
Yeah, thank you. Happy to be here.
And then we've got Cassie.
Old guest, been here a million times.
So why are you here?
So we're here to once again advertise and hopefully get more people to come out next Saturday, July 13th, to the Hillcats game, where we are having our annual Out of the Darkness fundraiser. And we will also have the Parrot Heads featured at the game this year.
Ah, all right. So tell us about the Parrot Heads.
The Heart of Virginia Parrot Head Club, as of September, will have been officially chartered as one of 200 international Parrot Head clubs.
Okay.
We will be 20 years old.
All right, and these are Jimmy Buffett,
Jimmy Buffett
aficionados.
And we live by his philosophy, especially us, because our mission is to party with a purpose for our community. We very much focus on and try to support organizations in our community.
I want to go to there. Party with a purpose.
Yes.
I like this. So when
if you go to the Hillcat Games, you can party with us.
So how did you get started with the Parrot Heads?
I started the Parrot Heads. I was just a Jimmy Buffett fan and was going to social events that were held by other clubs, like Richmond, North Carolina, and things, and thought, you know, I ran into people. Like I ran into Tom and Nancy at Big Lots, and so ran into people that really like Jimmy Buffett, and I like his philosophy of life, but laid back. And now we spend a lot of time reminiscing.
Nice. Yes.
And we spend a lot of time trying to. Last year we did Trees of Hope with Centra, and we did a blood drive. Also, which was it was an international blood drive for Gift of Light in honor and remembrance of Jimmy Buffett for cancer.
So now
we do a lot of different things.
Yeah. So now you're going to be in support of the Out of the Darkness night at the ballpark.
Yep.
Yes.
Very, very cool. Well, Kat, tell us about your involvement.
Yeah. So I joined the Parrot Head Club in about September of last year, right when he died.
Okay.
I always considered myself a Parrot Head, but I didn't really know that you could be an official Parrot Head, so I looked into it, and I joined our club, and I've been helping put together some events, because COVID kind of slowed us down, but I've been working to do that, and that's how we partnered with the American Foundation for Suicide Prevention.
Very, very cool. Well, Cassie, how are things going, and we can talk about the event, and we can also talk about the upcoming walk.
Yeah. So we're super excited for this year's walk. It's our 10th year, so 10-year anniversary of doing the Out of the Darkness walk here in Lynchburg. Yeah. So we're trying to make this our greatest and biggest event that we've had. So hopefully we'll get the numbers for turnout this year at Peaks View Park.
Okay.
Saturday, October 5th. And we are hoping to have as many vendors as possible this year, maybe some new ones that people haven't seen before.
Sure.
We'll have entertainment as always. So we're just really looking forward to everyone coming out, and we hope to see everyone in a week. It's almost a week from tomorrow at the game at the Hillcats.
Okay. And we hope we're invited to the walk to set up.
Absolutely.
We love to.
Well, this would be great. So it's Margaritaville night with live music. So hence the reason for the Parrot Heads to really be there and really come out in full force. It's the Out of the Darkness night at the ballpark. That's July 13. You can still get your tickets, and Now, a portion of the proceeds benefits your organization.
Yes, every ticket that is bought using either the link online through our event and the Hillcats for the Out of the Darkness specifically, we will have $4 from each ticket donated to our walk this year. We also have some physical tickets. If you aren't an online person and you want a ticket in your hand, just reach out to one of us on the Facebook page and we will get it to you.
Okay. So that again is July 13th. You can get online tickets for $10, day of game tickets for $14. First pitch at 6:30, but get there early and hang out. And you guys even have fireworks that night.
Fireworks, and we're going to have two special baskets being raffled off from the Parrot Heads Club as well.
Very, very cool. This sounds like a lot of fun.
Partying with a purpose.
And again, I want to go to there, Drake. We need to party with a purpose. Very much so.
I didn't know that Lynchburg had a Parrot Head Club.
Well, now you do.
Come join us.
I didn't know that existed.
Second Tuesday of every month at Big Licks.
Nice.
Big Licks makes sense.
Yeah. I mean, first Tuesday of every month.
It does.
Well,
first Tuesday of every month.
And we'll link up all this information, including the night at the ballpark.
Yeah.
We'll link up all the information about the Parrot Head Club as well. And the Out of the Darkness walk. We've been there from the beginning.
Yes.
With you guys and absolutely positively support your mission. It's a tremendous thing that you all are doing.
Thank you. Yes.
It is the Mike Show. Did we cover everything?
Did we get it?
Yeah.
All right. So I kind of want to know your interest in Jimmy Buffett. The music is incredible. The message is incredible. Well, where'd that all stem from?
Just, if people have different groups and things that they like, and I'm just like Jimmy Buffett, and I'm sort of like Kat in that it really just found out about it, and I researched it, and we decided that we had enough people to do it.
That's
here.
That's awesome.
And everybody that's with us, generally, we already had one event that we did at a winery and did a basket and raised
$500
for
that's tremendous.
The suicide prevention. So it's, people who would like to, and we generally follow that kind of thing. The particular winery happened to have Parrot Head music that night.
Nice.
So
very cool.
We had great support, but I just like Jimmy Buffett.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
And so those of us, we enjoy the music. We go to his concerts together and things like that. So it's been fun, and it creates great friendships, and it gets us out in the community doing things, little things to help our community.
Mm-hmm. Very cool. Well, we love it. Coming up a little bit later on, we have sounds, and we're going to place them in your ear holes. It's called Audio Vault. That is all on the way. Get out and support the Out of the Darkness night at the ballpark July 13th.
The Battle of 460 returns as the Lynchburg Hillcats face off against the Salem Red Sox July 1st through the 6th at Bank of the James Stadium. Join us for Independence Day celebration on Thursday with the biggest fireworks show in the Hill City. This year, we'll be honoring the historic Bedford Boys with specialty jerseys. Come back again on Friday as we give away a Hillcats Patriotic cap. Then on Saturday, we'll turn our attention to a galaxy far, far away with the Revenge of the 6th. Get your tickets today at Lynchburg-Hillcats.com.
This is Jackie.
Hi.
Jackie is feeling really good.
I sure am.
Tell everybody why, Jackie.
Well, because I've got my own care team at Centra.
You sure do.
Yep, I've got my doctor.
Leading your team.
My advanced practice provider.
Who's there if you're sick or for yearly visits.
And my registered nurse.
Leads your nursing team.
At Centra, I'm getting personal care from a team of experts.
No wonder you're feeling good.
Really good.
To learn how Centra can help you, like they're helping Jackie, go to CentraHealth.com.
Coming to you live from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their Factory Direct Warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at StonecraftersVA.com.
KHF!
All right, time once again for Nerd News. This week in science. It's just science. Don't be afraid. covering the most important news for your brains, or be very afraid. Here's what you may have missed. China. I said China.
Hello.
Hi. They landed a probe on the far side of the moon, and collected the first samples from the far side of the moon. Then lifted back off and came home.
Okay.
Did you hear about this?
No.
Yeah.
What were they getting?
Not cheese. Sunglasses can help you drive during the day, but a team from Australia is working on a thin plastic film that could be used to make special glasses for driving at night. That'd be like night vision goggles, but a little less bulky.
Yeah, I look over and some guy just has night vision goggles on.
And no headlights. In AI news.
Oh. I said in
AI news. Yeah. A former OpenAI employee said he thinks there's a 70% chance AI will destroy us all.
I did hear about that.
Yeah.
A lot of AI creators hate what they made.
So that's fun. And in health news, energy drinks loaded with taurine. Is that taurine?
Yeah, I think it's taurine. I think that's what it's called.
And let's get the Pronouncify lady. See if,
oh, here we go. Yep.
Yeah. See if we can get the correct pronunciation. how to pronounce
taurine?
All right. Oh, it's a Pronouncify
taurine.
Lady. Here we go.
Taurine.
Taurine.
That's so not what I thought it was.
Taurine.
Taurine.
She's irritated.
Taurine.
Energy drinks loaded with How do you say that again? It's a...
Taurine.
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 Might cause colon cancer.
I think I may need a kidney transplant.
Maybe. And a study found we get goosebumps a lot more than we realize.
Huh.
And then finally, in health news, the first drug designed to regrow teeth will be tested on humans this fall. What could possibly go wrong? They tried it in rats. And
a rat.
Yeah.
That's a rat.
And the rat's teeth were perfect. They were just like...
Just picture a rat with human teeth.
Yeah, they were perfect. So now they're going to try them. They're going to try them on humans.
Would you do that?
No, I don't. Well,
you started losing your teeth, you wouldn't be like, hey, let me regrow them.
Yeah, maybe. Who knows? I don't know. I'm not big on pharmaceuticals at all.
Same.
I'm not big on drugs. I'm not big on especially untested things.
Oh, yeah. This is so untested.
The first drug designed to regrow teeth. You know, I might end up... My butt might grow teeth.
Now I feel like it's going to be one of those things where, like, you have, like, horse teeth. Extremely big.
Yeah. Great big huge.
Or you'd grow fangs, man. You could have like a vampire.
Oh. Well, now, okay. I'm rethinking the not doing this.
But that would be like a thing gone wrong. They'd be like, we can't have that. We can't have your teeth turning into fangs.
Yeah, can't have that. Probably wouldn't be good. And that's your nerd news. This portion of the broadcast is brought to you in part by CMA's Honda of Lynchburg.
Looking for a dealership you can trust? CMA's Honda of Lynchburg is here for you. Our legacy of quality service speaks for itself. Drive away today in a Honda that's perfect for you. Trusted by the Lynchburg community for years. CMA's Honda of Lynchburg. Owners just care more.
There's nothing like holding a freshly grilled Jersey Mike's cheesesteak. It's even better than holding a winning $1 million lottery ticket. For starters, Uncle Sam takes half. Then you buy some useless stuff, like a tiny suit of armor for your cat. And before you know it, your sister's cousins and Uncle Frankie come knocking on your door for handouts. Bing, bang, boom, you're back to zero. So if you want to play a winning number, order a number 17 Mike's Famous Philly. Freshly grilled right in front of you. It's a Jersey Mike's thing. A sub above.
Three Roads Brewery is Lynchburg's gathering spot. Enjoy the relaxed open atmosphere of the Lynchburg Tap Room with plenty of space to unwind or outside on their expansive patio with friends and the entire family. Check out Three Roads games, arcade style, darts, and more. And of course, an excellent selection of craft beers brewed on site. Grab a Three Roads today at their tap room, 1300 Court Street, downtown Lynchburg, their tap room in Farmville, or anywhere they serve great beer. Three Roads is also available at area convenience stores and supermarkets. And if they don't carry Three Roads, ask them to. Brewing Community, Three Roads Brewery.
Lynchburg. Broadcasting from the Stonecrafters Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry shops, Stonecrafters' incredible inventory at their factory direct warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF.
All right, let's open it up. It is your audio vault for today. Our collection of bits and clips and viral audio for your ear holes. I think you'll like it. Well, are you looking for any fireworks? Get them before they're gone.
I'm Eddie Two Fingers from Two Fingers Fireworks, where we celebrate Independence Day every day. You know why they call me Two Fingers? I only got two fingers. Look at this. I started with 10 fingers, but now I'm down to two fingers. So you know the fireworks at Two Fingers Fireworks works great, yeah? All right, so come down to the area's largest selection of fireworks, guaranteed to take off your fingers. Two Fingers Fireworks. Yeah. One finger fireworks. We're right on the corner across from that guy with a meat truck.
Uh-huh. Ah. Oh, man. Okay. Remember the hilarious scene in Joe Dirt when he asked the guy at the fireworks stand a long list of what the guy doesn't have? Well, David Spade went to a real fireworks stand in Kentucky and started quoting lines from his movie while talking to the lady that works there. Here, listen.
You're gonna stand there
owning a fireworks stand.
Do a lot of people say that?
I'll say your godfather.
Where's the godfather? Oh my god, you think I got that kind of money?
It's $8.99.
$899?
Yeah.
So you're gonna tell me that you don't have no black cats, no Roman candles or screaming mimes?
No disco turkeys? Lava dome?
Or one single whistling kitty chaser?
What else you got?
Some firecrackers underneath the table.
Oh, is that the good stuff?
Let's see. What is this? Oh, man. Okay, Ozempic. I said Ozempic.
I think I may need a kidney transplant.
Maybe. Has helped a ton of people lose a ton of weight. Now, a study found one possible side effect could be sudden blindness. That's a sudden blindness. Yeah. Here's a woman from Ohio talking about losing her eyesight when taking the drug.
It was as if someone had thrown a switch. Legally, I could no longer drive at night. She said, your distance and night vision is gone. They said there's probably more people out there that are having vision problems, but they're not coordinating it with the Ozempic.
Wow. A flight from Delta from Detroit to Amsterdam had to make an emergency landing in New York City. New York City! After passengers were served spoiled food and dozens of people got sick.
I think I may need a kidney transplant.
Here's one of the passengers, Barbara Smith, talking about what had happened.
I don't eat on airplanes for this very reason. The captain came on and said, hey, we're actually going to have to reroute the plane because there's contaminated food and they don't feel comfortable sending us across the Atlantic. There were people on the plane who you could see getting up, going back and forth to the bathroom, and then also as well. I hope that they can rectify the situation. It definitely does leave a bad taste in my mouth, no pun intended.
All right. Let's see. Had a whole bunch of stuff here. Let's go to another viral video. Here's a video of a guy leaning over a boat and tapping the water when a small gator swims up. The man then grabs the gator's bottom jaw and uses one of the gator's teeth to puncture a beer can. Then he passes it to an excited dude on board the boat who immediately shotguns the beer. Good lord. You know, do we even need to add, please don't try this if you happen upon a gator, and maybe that's also a little cruel. What else? Okay. We wrap up Audio Vault with a comedian, and today is no exception. Here is comedian Ryan Hamilton on his small town's 4th of July parade.
We have a big parade every year on the 4th of July. It's the biggest event in my town every year. There are 500 people in the parade and 500 people who are watching the parade. We have exactly enough people to have a parade. If someone stays home, they're kind of ruining the parade. Here's what I love about the parade is after it's over, nobody leaves. Nobody has anywhere to go. There's only one suitable street in my town for a parade. And when the parade gets out of town, it doesn't know what to do either. And there's this moment of confusion. And then it just flips around and it comes back. And everybody just watches the other side of the parade again.
Uh-huh.
Where's the music? I played, oh, there it is. I started the music.
I was typing. I'm sorry. I'm attempting to multitask. We'll catch up next week. Have a good one. Have a good day. How about have a good day? There we go. Have a good day. All right. Send. There. Sorry. Sorry, attempting. Okay, so we had some minor technical difficulties this morning that got the show started a lot later than what we ordinarily would get it started. And so now we're, you know, I'm having to multitask. I apologize. That's your audio vault for today. Let's reach over here and lovingly grab the handle. Go ahead, give it a tug. Keep all that sound inside. This portion of the broadcast is brought to you in part by Jersey Mike's Subs.
At Jersey Mike's, they slice your order fresh right in front of you. And let me tell you, watching that can send a rush of emotions through a person. Excitement, impatience, baby-like wonder, indecisive, anticipatory chewing, nervous pacing, happy claps, and finally, jealousy, because that's this guy's sub. I should order one. Good idea.
Sliced right in front of you. It's a Jersey Mike's thing. A sub above.
Hi, I'm Matt Bright, the new owner of CRI Digital Impressions. And I'm excited to announce a new chapter in the century-long history of CRI. Mutual Press was founded in 1927, and in 1973 it merged with CRI to become CRI Mutual Press. In 2002, it was renamed CRI Digital Impressions. I also own Bright Images, which has provided print and media services to the area since 1995. Yes, there is a new owner and a new location, but the same commitment to quality and service. In fact, quality and service are the cornerstones of my business philosophy. Quick turns and service with a smile. From business cards to banners and pamphlets to paperback books, we can provide all your printing needs. Call, visit us online, or stop by our location at 3022 Memorial Avenue, Lynchburg. We look forward to serving you.
From brand new to lightly used, CMA's Honda of Lynchburg's got you covered. Shop our growing selection today and find our best deals on our entire inventory. That's savings on every single vehicle. And on our used cars, take 3 days to love it or leave it. Plus, we'll buy your current vehicle. Trade in with us and get an unbeatable offer. Start shopping and saving today. CMA's Honda of Lynchburg. Owners just care more.
Coming to you live from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their factory direct warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF!
Sorry. Time once again for Stupid Criminals in Da News. All right. Sorry about that. Oh, I'm on the wrong screen. Don't do that. Fix this and go to here. And should I just take to it? No? All right. Whatever. Time once again for Stupid Criminals in Da News. A 19-year-old woman in El Paso, Texas, named Stacy Smith, is facing charges after going too above and beyond to help out a friend. She called 911 on Sunday and said her small child was in a car that got stolen. But the kid didn't exist. She was just trying to help get her friend's car back. The car was stolen, but there wasn't a kid in it. Police say she made it up because she thought they might find the friend's car faster. The good news is her idea worked. Police tracked the car down after an extensive search. The bad news is she then had to fess up and tell them to stop looking for the kid because there was no child. They arrested her for falsifying a police report and held her on $5,000 bond. It's not clear if they've caught the car thief. Okay, I'm not showing that. That's her mugshot. Then there is this. Scroll. Police had to break up a fight on a golf course in Vancouver the other day. Someone apparently hit into the group in front of them several times, and that's what sparked it. There's a video of multiple people beating a man lying on the ground. Here are area golfers commenting on the brawl.
That is shocking. I think those guys should be banned for a year from golfing.
If you do that once, you should probably be very judicious from that point afterwards. Like, you know, if you hit into a group once, once is enough.
There's no need for violence at any time, for any reason.
Okay. All right. A woman in Tennessee got arrested after she was caught with bags of meth, LSD, fentanyl, and other drugs, all disguised to look like Taco Bell burritos. She was wanted in three separate countries, by the way.
Yo quiero Taco Bell.
Do we have another one? We did the alligator story, but that's not stupid criminals. We did this one. Nope, we didn't do that one, but we're not going to do that one. We didn't do this one. No, I think we got everything, except for the good news. So let's find the good news. Here we go. A police dog in Texas named Indy recently retired after 9 years of sniffing out drugs and busting bad guys. His department paid tribute by announcing his retirement over police radio and listing his many accomplishments. Here is Indy's big announcement.
After 9 years of dedicated service, K-9 Indy is retiring and signing off for his final shift. K-9 Indy has made a significant throughout his tenure. Indy has assisted over 38 local and federal law enforcement agencies, serving as an ambassador to the community and a trusted partner and friend to his handler, Sergeant Barry Sullivan. Thank you, K-9 Indy, for your service. We wish you a happy retirement.
What do you say? We appreciate it, County.
Aww. And there you go. And that is the good news. All right. The good news is brought to you in part by the United Way of Central Virginia.
Well, being on the board is an amazing experience because you get to find out a lot about the community and what the needs of the community are. United Way is in the business of changing lives.
43,669 of our neighbors cannot afford the basic costs of living. United Way programs were able to provide 99,500 meals to families.
I am the change.
Visit our website, Be the Change, and donate today.
Visit UnitedWayCV.org for more information. And this supports the United Way of Central Virginia. It is Hill City Slide, coming to Lynchburg, downtown Lynchburg to be exact. This is going to be set up on Church Street between 12th and Washington, a 700-some-foot water slide. You will be able to slide down Church Street from just above where the YMCA is all the way down to where the Armory is on 12th Street. That's going to be set up August 24th and 25th. You have to purchase tickets in advance. Go to hillcityslide.com to reserve your time and your slide tickets. HillCitySlide.com, and the proceeds benefit the United Way of Central Virginia. Again, that is August 24th and 25th, downtown Lynchburg. Learn more, HillCitySlide.com. And if you're looking for something to do, well, how about tomorrow? Here, let me click on that. Let's share the screen, bring it up. Boom. There we go. It is Christmas in July at Three Roads Brewery, 1300 Court Street in downtown Lynchburg. Tomorrow, Santa Claus, Summer Santa, will be on hand. He'll be meeting with the kids. Get your list. Bring your kids. It's all family friendly. You can check out the tap room and meet up with Summer Santa. He's going to be there from 1 to 3. We have the Love LYH Punk Rock Flea Market They're going to be popping in from 11 to 4. We've got live music as well at Three Roads. So come on out and join us tomorrow, Saturday, Christmas in July with Summer Santa and Three Roads Brewing, 1300 Court Street. Okay, that is it. That is the program. We are back Monday.
Goodbye.
Don't come back.
No, we're back Monday with another thrilling edition of The Mike Show. I want to thank everybody for joining us. We want to thank Drake for sitting in. Drake, you may know him from either Three Roads or the record store down on Jefferson Street or Super Rad. Drake is everywhere. He's going to be helping us out with the show from time to time. Might even be a new producer here at Commerce Street Podcast Studios and The Mike Show. So thanks, Drake. Welcome. Also, we want to thank Gail, Kat, and Cassie for joining us. They have an event coming up. It's all in support of the Out of the Darkness Walks. It's a fundraiser at your Lynchburg Hillcats. And you can learn more if you scroll back through our social media. You'll see the links at The Mike Show VA. That is it. That is the program. We will see you Monday.
Thanks for tuning our way. And if you're listening in your car right now, thanks for the ride.
Scotty, beat me up.
I'm Ron Burgundy. Don't just have a great night, have an American night.
Who's going to do the dishes?